Continue.
Listen, that's fresh. .com. Don't forget the .com.
Bitch.
Scarfed up.
Here, Memphis. Bitch. Because you didn't know. This right here, T. MF and Lil.
Motherfucking.
Person behind the camera, also. In case you didn't know.
Yeah.
So today, right now, we talk about a couple of things. Right now, we're going to talk about trying to do the right thing in 2010. We eat healthy. But let me tell you what the problem is. It's costly. Like, you have to have stacks on deck to eat right.
You got to have more to eat fucked up. I mean,
not really. Why do you think half the world is obese? It's a dollar for a cheeseburger.
Because they asses are too lazy to cook good shit.
No, fuck that. $2.99, the new Wendy's commercial. Right. Goddamn chicken deluxe, fries, and a drink for $2.99.
You see what I'm saying? And then how much you gonna pay for a salad? How much?
$5. $6. Zaxby's what?
$7 for some shit that's gonna fuck me up.
Ruben Tuesday's $8.
You see what I'm saying?
Add another dollar till you get the mini burgers. Where they do that at?
That's all I'm saying. So you want me to lose weight? You want me to be healthy? But yet you gonna tax me? What kind of shit is that? So you want me to die early. You see what's going on here? You see this? It's a conspiracy going on. Anyway, we're off that. You ready, Fresh?
I'm cooling, baby. Y'all need to get my nails right, man.
Hey, we're going tomorrow. You
take care of yourself, man, because ladies, look at your hands.
Get a manicure.
We going tomorrow. You coming?
Huh?
We got shit, too.
We personal shit. All right. So, anyway.
My bad.
Damn. like, these niggas talking about... All right, so, good people, I have a public announcement to make, and this is real serious shit that's really kind of hurting my heart, right? And I'm going to speak on it, and I'm actually going to need you guys' help. I'm going to do some research myself. I haven't actually started yet, but... Last week, I felt some kind of way, so I'm going to try to do my research and see what was all true and what's good, all right? Everybody knows the Dream, right? You know this guy.
Of course
we do. Mr. Falsetto.
You know what I'm saying? Shorty Mr.
Right
Falsetto.
There,
you know what I'm saying? Shorty's a 10. Used to sing Right Hand to Dream back in the day, them booty shake days. I want to fuck you. Yeah, that's him. Do your research. All right,
got
so.
Got Electric Red. I like
that. Yeah, that's his artist right there. All right, this was going on. Last week, you know what I'm saying, me and my homegirls was talking, and it was telling me, like, did you hear about the Dream today? The Dream was going off on his Twitter. It was going off, talking about how it's for the second long time in a row, he didn't get nominated for a Grammy. Now, in my mind, I was thinking, his first album, I dug it. It was cool, but it wasn't a classic to me. Now, the second album, it was ridiculous. The only other two motherfuckers I could say that compares to him
right now,
album wise, was fucking Trey Songz and Jamie Foxx. If
you're
really gonna go to the goddamn
critiques,
Swartz, right? So I guess the thinking, I'm like, damn, I'm talking about all this work he be doing on production, he be writing for motherfuckers, and y'all still not giving this man his just due, right? Okay. So I'm like, I need to figure out how a way I can contact him and do an interview with him, because I want to speak on it, because. Honestly, I don't think it's right.
Nobody's showing him no love.
And this is what This is how I'm feeling right now. I'm really, really starting to feel that this Grammy shit is all a popularity fucking contest now. It's all about whoever had the best promotion, that's who's going to get the slot.
Whoever names out there more.
Let me tell you like this. Not to downplay Melanie Fiona at all. She's cool. She's dope. She's nominated for a Grammy, right?
That makes no
sense.
But
the thing is, you only known her name since September.
Just the past couple months.
For that one song she had before that, what was that? Do the Right? I can't remember, but y'all know that shit. You got it from an old sample. But, you know what I'm saying? That just gave her a little sprinkle out there. Nobody really knew who she was until It Kills Me came out, which was in September, right? In August, whatever the case. Regardless of the fact, you can really only give a really whole 2 months of this.
But she got a nomination.
Real talk for a Grammy now. In which I'm in thinking, because I tried to look it up, I couldn't find out who she was nominated with, but in a nutshell, whoever's in that category, I'm pretty sure she wasn't even relevant when them songs was out. Point blank, period. But you got
to
do.
But not to hate on her, because I
not
like
to
her
hate,
too.
Not to hate on her at all. Like, she's a great fucking artist. It's just that
it's too
you
early.
Haven't been here long enough
right.
to. Not to the masses. You know what I'm saying? Like, I heard I was digging you last year, but people didn't know you last year like that. But it's now, you know what I'm saying, with some good promotion, and you got a nice-ass song, 2 months in, you nominated. When you got somebody like The Dream,
who's been
out here like 2 years now, and killing them. You know what I'm saying?
Writing songs way before those
2 years. Yeah, but it's just that, get like the, for the music he makes, just give him his just due. Mm-hmm. But I'm gonna tell you what I think it is. When it comes down to it, the Grammys is not the BET Awards.
Right.
Not to even make this a race card thing, but for the people that's behind the Grammys, they're not actually going to get the Dream's music like they would, you know what I'm saying, somebody else they put in that category. What I'm saying is, if y'all think about it,
I want
y'all to really think about what this when I tell y'all this. We're talking about the Dream. If you had to put him in a hip-hop category or R&B category, what would you do?
R&B.
No.
To us?
No.
Now, honestly, to us, we would put him in the R&B category.
I would put him
Why would you not?
Understand. We're not talking about us. We're talking about those people.
Right.
Those people. Understand the Dream, the music that he makes that real hard Atlanta bass.
Yeah.
I'm going to talk how the fuck I feel I'm a rapper.
Right.
But he sings it.
He's like boxing him into the
hip hop. Yeah, basically. Yeah. And I'm not saying that's what happened, but I'm saying
I'm pretty
sure that's what they're thinking. They're not thinking that he's making real R&B music.
It's hard to put him in that category.
He's not a real singer, I'm pretty sure, to a lot of motherfuckers. But he does have an accent and voice, and it just works for him. You know what I'm saying? It's just like a fucking auto tune almost. But
so they can't give him shit like best vocals and stuff like that because he's not what it is.
Jamie Foxx at all.
Well,
he knows that, but he know how to make good fucking music.
Basically,
you know what I'm saying? So just don't play him like he's not hot. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, everybody else they appreciate he wrote or he produced. Even across out of their R&B box, you know. On the pop side, he wrote Jesse McCartney's Leaving. He did Mary J. Blige's Just Fine. They love that one. Give him his just due. He deserves it. Outside of his singing, he's got his writing and his producing. He deserves it.
Real talk, man. So Big Homie goes in. What I'm doing right now, I'm going to try to see who I can contact to try to see if I can get an interview with him, put it on the air, internet, whatever it is. Because, I mean, I want to talk about it because I'm really feeling like people really don't, downplay him. For the shit that he made.
Okay,
you know what I'm
so put a pin in that, Fresh.
Mm-hmm.
You talk about the auto-tune and it's actually not being his voice or whatever. But you got Kanye who did, like, the whole first...
I mean, that's the Dream. What I'm saying is, that's the Dream's voice.
Exactly.
But it's just that it's not your natural singer's voice. It's an accent, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
He's like an extra on the track, almost. You know what I'm saying? But it's just that for the kind of voice... Well, yeah, for the voice that he has, though, he know how to make a hot-ass song with
it.
It
works for him.
Okay. So to play devil's advocate, how the hell is Wayne doing it?
Wayne, he's a rapper.
Exactly. They're going to put him in a rap song. Exactly. You know what I'm saying? Exactly.
They're going to put T-Pain
in
there,
too. They're going to put
T-Pain that's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
That makes no sense.
That's how it's going
to
go, though.
Okay.
It makes no sense, but that's how it's going. So
back to the basics.
Yeah, so I really want to talk about this shit. Like, what the fuck's going on? You know what I'm saying? Because, honestly, I don't remember maybe one award show I think he probably won.
Who, Dream?
Yeah, The Dream. Can you think of
one? He was nominated for a Grammy, but he never got it.
I don't remember. He said he was never nominated.
I don't remember.
That's what I'm just sitting here thinking. I don't recall
he
at
said
all.
That
he
was,
not at all. That's he was nominated.
He said that's what was the word.
He wrote on.
From what I've heard, he said he was never nominated.
That's what I'm just sitting here thinking about.
He
not even on no MTV Awards. I don't even remember.
Nothing.
Well,
Umbrella
was nominated, but he didn't get it. They lost to
somebody.
Amy Winehouse.
So if that's the case, then that's one thing. But I think if they telling me
but it wasn't him directly.
Yeah, I'm saying like if they telling me how I think they telling me they talking about
him.
Yeah.
Yeah, he wasn't directly.
Love versus Money is not in Best Album of the Year.
Makes no fucking sense on me.
Nobody.
I think Best Album of the Year right now is Black Eyed Peas, Dave Matthews Band, Taylor Swift, Lady Gaga, and Black Eyed Peas.
All the shit, the people that we ride with, the shit that we see every day, they don't even listen to none of that.
Like Jay-Z didn't even. Blueprint 3 didn't even make it.
Didn't
exactly.
What? What?
Exactly.
They make it.
Exactly.
I don't get it.
Exactly.
Nope.
So.
Exactly.
So, hey, it is what it is, good people. So, yo, if y'all got a contact on The Dream, tell them to holler at the world wide homeboy, djfresh.com. We're going to get this shit on air, put it out there. Like, nigga, what the fuck is really going on, all right? We're going to be back.
What is
Peace and love.